The objective of this lesson is to become familiar with the types of guiding planes used in removable partial dentures, and to understand when they are used. Guiding planes are defined as two or more parallel vertical surfaces of abutment teeth, so shaped to direct a prosthesis during placement and removal. Potential guiding planes are located with the dental surveyor in the diagnostic phase, are prepared on tooth surfaces to be vertically parallel, and to define the path of insertion. Ideally, they are prepared in the long axis of the tooth. They may be contacted by many rigid components of the RPD, but most often are contacted using a proximal plate. The ideal path of insertion for an RPD is perpendicular to the plane of occlusion.
This orientation is usually the easiest for a patient to negotiate when placing and removing the RPD. Guiding planes are mutually parallel with the path of insertion and ensure that the RPD seats with minimal strain to the abutments and that components are located correctly. The guiding planes allow the RPD to be seated along a predictable path. Since the only flexible component of the RPD is the flexible retentive clasp, the guiding planes permit seating with less potential for stress and component fracture. Guiding planes provide frictional direct retention, enhance lateral stability, and limit vertical dislodgement of the RPD to the path opposite the path of insertion, that is, one path into place, one path out. When prepared on tip teeth, they may be used to reduce food traps.
Guiding planes rarely occur naturally, and almost without exception must be prepared, usually on the mesial and or distal interproximal surfaces adjacent to the edentulous space. They are more effective if widely spaced and diverge in the buccolingual orientation. The guiding plane does not result in the creation of a sharp proximal line angle. The accuracy of preparation ultimately can only be verified with a dental surveyor. Guiding planes are either long or short. Long guiding planes are used adjacent to tooth-bound spaces. Short guiding planes are used adjacent to extension bases. The diagrams illustrate how they should be formed. Both follow the external buccolingual convex contour of the tooth, with slightly more off the lingual to make the proximal plate thicker. They are flat in the vertical dimension, and mutually parallel with other guiding planes.
The illustration above shows the long and short guiding plane concept. Some schools teach the linear point contact. Note the convex buccolingual contour of the guiding plane. The lone standing abutment, usually a maxillary second premolar, is frequently encountered. The illustration shows that guiding planes prepared on adjacent surfaces should diverge in a buccal direction to reduce stress. The table illustrates location and type of guiding planes appropriate for various situations. Please be familiar with the information provided.